technology is changing faster than ever before. The advances in a series of technologies during the last few years has been exponential. But what does exponential growth mean? And why is now different than anything we have seen before? Are we just turning into an unprecedented convergence of disruptive technologies? A new awakening of our ways of living? So if you want to understand how exponential technologies are affecting our world, buckle up and get ready to discover the implications of the fourth industrial revolution. Fourth Industrial Revolution is a name chosen by the World Economic Forum, but there are many other names that you might have read. Books such as The Second Machine Age, Industry 4.0, or many others. Some people are even saying that what is happening is beyond an industry is affecting the whole society, is not just limited to industries. But let's say we take Fourth Industrial Revolution. First Industrial Revolution started in United Kingdom, which was the pioneer of the first industrial revolution in 17th and 18th century. Most of it was built on steam, but there were other machines also. We have industrialized a lot of our production, which eventually led into the second industrial revolution. At the end of the 19th and the beginning of the 20th century, electricity became a big deal, and we have also designed new ways to produce things which we scalable, such as assembly lines. Finally, we had a revolution in information technologies and computing, which we are at the end of, starting in the 50s and 60s and full coming to fruition at the beginning of the 21st century. I think it's fair to say that even today we are still feeling the impact of the last one and how much it has changed our world. We are now at the beginning stages of the fourth industrial revolution. It might seem that we are quite far into it, but we are still at the beginning, and I'll explain in a second why. If you consider how much the world has changed in the previous industrial revolutions, it's by no means an understatement to assume that there are big changes ahead of us. These are some technologies that are making up the fourth industrial revolution, although there are more of them than you can see here. We can start on top. We have artificial intelligence, which is both a narrow artificial intelligence, which means specific applications of artificial intelligence. There are also advancements being done in artificial general intelligence, although comparatively, it is much less advanced still. Then we have blockchain and cryptocurrencies. I assume most of you are familiar with these, but I still think that the potential of what these mean for the global economic and financial system has not yet been explored at all. Another is biotechnology, then augmented and virtual reality and drones. This is a small drone. But a big drone can also be called a flying car, which are advancing forward as well. Next is solar energy and energy in general, especially renewable energies, quantum computing. The one on the picture is a quantum computer that is already built. It's from a company called Rigetti, and you can go online and rent the space on this quantum computer for your quantum computer applications. You can actually program it, it's now in the cloud, and you can run quantum computing applications. Finally, there are digital manufacturing, self-driving cars, and robotics. So those are some of the technologies that are happening all at once. In reality, it's more like 20 within a matter of moments, which are all happening at the same time. You may remember Gutenberg when he came with a printing press. It completely changed how we as society and humanity disseminate knowledge. And we now have the equivalent of 20 Gutenberg moments happening all at once. For all these reasons, I think it's fair to say that the world is changing faster than anyone has predicted. One of the key reasons for this is the underlying dynamic behind those technologies and why they are growing so fast. These technologies, we call them exponential technologies because they are all powered by information technology, information science. This means Moore's law applies, which means that for more than 50 years, the price performance of microchips doubles roughly every 18 months, roughly. Exponential progression and doubling pattern are very deceptive, as it grows very slow for a very long time and then suddenly explodes. It seems that nothing is happening, but then suddenly, everything is different. All the technologies we mentioned are powered by information and microchips, which also means they are subject to Moore's law, and that means that they are indeed very deceptive. Let me show how. If I ask you now to stand up and go 30 steps, you know pretty much where you're going to be at any point of the journey. At the end, you will be 30 meters in the direction you choose, and you can estimate very well where you will be at any given point of the journey. You can estimate where halfway will be, where two-thirds is, etc. Linear progression is quite easy to understand and is predictable. However, if I ask you to take 30 exponential steps, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, this is one kind of exponential progression, doubling at every step. This is what happens. You will reach billion meters, which is roughly an equivalent of being 27 times around the Earth. This is quite different to the linear progression, but what is most shocking around this is that it is impossible to predict where you're going to be halfway through or elsewhere because our minds are not used to thinking that way. Let's have a look at this. If you take 15 steps, which is normally halfway to the final destination, you won't even reach 0.01% of your total distance. You can see the rest of the numbers on the screen. 20 steps, 25 steps actually, the last 5 steps account for 97%, almost all of the final result. And again, this only happened in the last 5 steps. This is something that is very hard for us to understand. All the technologies we are speaking about, they have been developing for many years, sometimes for decades, but they are now entering into a phase where they are moving to the steeper part of the curve, which is what makes things quite unpredictable. This one picture says it all. It is a prediction of world's experts about the rate of growth of photovoltaic panels, essentially, growth in adoption of solar energy. They are yearly predictions of top experts predicting how much the market will grow each year. You can see that each year, experts predicted an incremental growth or even decline in the market. But the black line is actually what happened. It is growing exponentially and fast, even as the experts forecasted small growth or even decline. It is staggering to me that for so many years, the expert predictions were completely wrong. The reality went on exponential curve and nobody has noticed that. They are all super smart people, educated in everything and experts in this industry. It just shows how difficult it is for us as human beings to kind of get that. Actually, it turns out that experts are not very good at predicting the future just because they are usually predicting in a linear way, not exponentially. And this is why people like Elon Musk can appear very crazy at the beginning, but then can produce some amazing outcomes further down the line. This is our estimate. We are right at the knee of the curve. This is why we believe our future is being defined as we speak, and there are incredible business opportunities ahead. All these technologies have been developing quietly for years, sometimes decades, but all of them are hitting the knee of the curve now, or in the next few years. And that will change our world in fundamental ways and as shape our future. However, there is one more thing happening. While each of these technologies is disruptive on its own, because many of them are hitting the knee of the curve just about now, their convergence is what creates an unprecedented and previously unseen pace of change. Let me give you an example. Let's speak about flying cars. Flying cars have been appearing in science fiction literature for around 100 years. In fact, many people were sure that in the year 2000 or for sure, in the year 2020, we would have been zipping around in flying cars at our leisure. However, this hasn't happened yet. In fact, Peter Thiel, a Silicon Valley venture capitalist, said that as a critique of the tech industry, "We wanted flying cars, and what we got was 140 characters. He was making fun in part, but also asking a serious question. Why are we not building flying cars? And one of the reasons was that until now, the technology to make it happen simply didn't exist. However, what is happening now is that thanks to the convergence of multiple exponential technologies, it is becoming finally possible. As we mentioned, each one of these technologies is by themselves disruptive, but when they start to converge together, amazing things become possible. It is now predicted that we will see fully operational and available flying cars within this decade. In the past 3 years, investors have poured $7 billion USD into a new generation of electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, also known as eVTOL. There are some of technologies that were developed for a diverse set of applications, but when they are brought together, they can make the flying car a reality. Distributed electric propulsion means you can have multiple engines that coordinate and operate quietly, which is very different than a helicopter, with one loud, large, noisy engine, which also happens to be very dangerous. With distributed electric propulsion, you have multiple engines that are quiet, and all coordinated via AI algorithms that can synchronize the small engines. This is needed because it's impossible for a pilot to do it manually, so this development needed to happen to make this system possible. Then you have things like LiDAR, accelerometer, GPS, and other tracking devices, which were developed in other places like self-driving cars and mobile phones, but they happen to be very useful for a flying car. Thanks to developments and research in solar energy, we now also have batteries that are capable to store enough power to fuel the flying car for as long as it needs. We have advanced computer simulations that can design better shapes and materials. New materials have appeared in material science. And 3D printers are now actually able to print whole parts and sections which wasn't possible before. Today, we can print large percentage of an aircraft engine, which is incredible when you think of it, as the sophistication and safety requirements of these are huge. Because of all these technologies, the flying car is finally possible. But not only flying cars, the future is faster than you think. Convergence of technology is speeding things up. As such, it is important for us to keep asking about the future and study resources that can help us to better peek into and understand the future. Ray Kurzweil famously said we are about to experience 20,000 years of technological progress in just 100 years. That's basically from agricultural revolution 10,000 years ago to the present moment twice within the next century. Very, very fast. Are you excited about the possibilities of exponential technologies? Or do you think they pose a threat to the traditional ways of living? We want to hear your thoughts, so drop a comment below and let us know what you think. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.